another yoga studio. I'm Kat, for those of you who haven't tried one of our videos before, and it's lovely to have everyone on the mat with me again today. So today we have a restorative yoga class, so it's very, very slow, very, very relaxing, and it's all about just taking time to allow the body to release, the mind to release, give ourselves a chance to breathe. And we're going to use lots of things to cushion and support us. So if you're someone who has things like lots of yoga bolsters and blocks, then go and grab those. You find as much as you can to help support you here as we go through the few little poses we're going to do. If you've not got any particular equipment, it doesn't matter. Just find as many cushions, pillows, rolled up blankets, towels, anything that you've got that you can use to make yourself feel comfortable. All we want to be able to do is bring the floor to us instead of us having to force ourselves down to the floor. So once you've got all your bits and pieces that you're going to need, we're going to come to lie down on the mat. Okay, so we're going to start with placing something for the head. So whatever it is that you've got to use, and then something in underneath the knees. Now, if you have got another blanket that you like, or a large towel or anything like that, that you want to place over the top of you, just to keep you feeling nice and warm and comfortable and relaxed as well, then of course, you can cover yourself up with a blanket at any point. So when you're ready, we're gonna come to lie down. Just take any adjustment that you need to make sure that you feel supported under your knees and supported under your head. If you'd like to stack up and put more pillows, blankets, bolsters, whatever you've got underneath you, feel free. And we're going to start with the hands coming in, with one hand on the belly, one hand on the chest. And we're just going to begin to breathe. We don't need to force or control the breathing in any way. Simply just noticing the breathing. As that awareness of the breath increases, see if then you can begin to bring that little bit of control over the breath. So if possible, we're breathing in through the nose and out through the nose. See if you can begin to slow breathing down. We're trying to fill the belly and fill the chest with breath. So maybe you feel the belly and the chest expand with each breath in, underneath the hands, underneath the fingers. And as you exhale, feel the belly and the chest fall back to the floor. So So we're going to take a few even breaths. So we're going to count to four as we inhale and count to four as we exhale. So on your next inhale, we're going to start to inhale, two, three, four. Exhale, two, three, four. 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 So to see if you can keep that rhythm going in your own head, inhaling for four counts, exhaling for four counts. Do that five more times. Inhaling to four in your head, exhaling to four as you count in your head. Then we're letting the counting go. But keep that awareness of the breathing. And if you find at all that you start to, you know, lose the focus on the breath, the mind starts to wander as we hold our restorative poses now, just come back to thinking inhale, count to four, exhale, count to four. Bring the focus back to the breathing and finding the depth of the breath down through the body. So we're going to start off with a twist. So we're going to just bend the knees, and this is where you can use your cushions and your blocks to help you come into the twist. So we're going to start with just trying to open the arms out to the side and roll the knees over to the right. Now if you find that you're very open in your twist, you may feel that here you feel very supported, very comfortable, and that you can then just let the head roll the other way, maybe moving the cushion from underneath the head, if that doesn't feel right. And you just leave the floor as your comfort, as your support. If you find that you're not so open in your twist today, then bring one pillow, one cushion, whatever it is, maybe your blanket round to the right side, and we're gonna let the knees then stay supported on the cushion. If the left knee doesn't feel like it can comfortably close, you can even go for an extra pillow on the top. Or maybe you can bring the right knee round and you're just going to keep onto the floor and you're going to use the left, put a little cushion under the left knee for support. So this is all about making you feel as comfortable and supported as you can. The aim is to relax. We want to relax. So no tension in the body, no having to work to hold ourselves in the twist. If it doesn't feel quite right underneath the arm, underneath the shoulder, you've got an option of putting your folded up blanket, your cushion, underneath the left arm for support there. And then we're going to roll the head to the left side. Now we're here for about 10 to 12 minutes. So you just need to, obviously it's hard because we're working through a video here, but just trust in the silence that your video is still playing. And come back to your breathing. We have nothing to do, nowhere to go, nothing to think about. Just lying here, letting the left side of the body open out, and all we need to do is think about the breathing. Feelings, sensations, emotions come as we work through our yoga today. Just let them come, notice them, see if you can let them go. Sometimes when we hold these poses for a long time, we start to release tension, emotion in the body. Allow whatever comes up to come up. And if at any point you do need to come out of your twist or any of the other poses, just bring yourself out of it, give yourself a moment, and then maybe you'll feel ready to come back. Keep following the breathing. Remember, if the mind wanders and you lose the breath, just come back to start, noticing the start of the inhale, start of the exhale. So you can keep that breath even, inhaling for four, exhaling for four. Just for a few more breaths. When you're ready, just gently start to think of moving the fingers and the toes, gently rolling the head back into the middle, roll the knees back into the center. If you'd like to just take a little hug of the knees, you can. And then we're going to move the twist to the other side. So rolling the knees to the left side then this time, and then rearrange your cushions, your blankets, your bolsters as best suits you for this side. So remember, if you want something underneath the bottom knee, put something under the bottom knee. If again, you just want to maybe have a cushion between both knees, you can. If you want to support the right arm then this time, we're supporting the right arm and the right shoulder with your blanket or your cushion or your pillow. So again, we want to make sure we feel as comfortable as possible to this side, and then let the head roll if possible to look to the right. And we are here again for a little while as we focus again on the breathing. you've either got the eyes focused in one spot or closing the eyes. Personal choice here. Remember, if you do need to, just bring yourself out of the pose, feel free to. This is your practice. It's your time to look after your body, your breathing, your mind. So do what you know feels right. As we stretch the muscles, fascia here, if you feel that your body's asking you to just make a little adjustment somewhere, perhaps as you, maybe you release and body just wants to move a little deeper, just listen to the body, make any small, subtle movements, adjustments that you need to keep your body very gently releasing and stretching here. Remember, we keep coming back to the breathing. If you find your mind starts to wander, just come back to that even counting of inhale 4, exhale 4. Just here for a couple more breaths. And then slowly make your way back into the middle. Yeah. Take a little hug of the knees if you need it. And then roll round on back onto your side so you can slowly push yourself up to sitting. So we're going to come into a supported fold. So some suggestions for how to support ourselves here. So remember, use your blocks, use your bolsters, use cushions, blankets, whatever you've got. So you might find it feels a lot more comfortable. Bearing in mind, we are going to be sitting in our fold for quite a length of time again. It might be nice to just prop yourself up underneath the hips and maybe put a rolled up blanket there. And then if you know, maybe you've got tight hamstrings, or if you have knees that hyperextend and you tend to find that they push back into the floor, you could also place a little cushion or again a rolled up blanket or towel underneath the backs of the knees. And then we're going to make a nice little stack on top of the thighs. So just kind of work out what feels best for you and for your body. Sit tall, relax the shoulders, and when you're ready, we're going to exhale and just lean forwards onto your little stack of blankets, pillows, whatever you've got. So you can adjust your support, your stacking here. Maybe you feel like you need a little bit extra. Maybe you feel you've gone too far. Sort of awareness of a very gentle stretch, but what we don't want in these restorative poses is big, strong stretch feelings as if the body is working here. It's all just about allowing the body to very gently open and relax on its own. Again, over here, if you find that anything, there's emotion, tension, anything releases here, just allow it to come up. See if you can breathe, let it pass. You need to take some time for yourself to just deal with whatever comes up, then that's absolutely fine. But just see if you can just stay here and focus on the breathing, allowing that tension, that emotion to go. So much tension and emotion and stress that gets stored in the body, whether that's negative or positive. How the body
to the next, how the body is going to react to your yoga. here for those last few breaths. Now fold. Just slowly start to walk your hands back up so you can come up to sitting. Take a little bit of movement through the legs, through the feet, the ankles if you need it, and slowly shift your blocks out the way. And then we're going to come back to lie down on the floor. So again, if it helps to put something behind the back of the head, our next pose, we're going to put something underneath the head, but we're going to come into a bridge pose, but we're going to come into a supported bridge. So we want to stack up as much as we can underneath the hips, as much as feels comfortable. So if it helps, just to shift to the side for a minute. We're going to pile, maybe you've got a bolster or something that you can put underneath your hips. Coming to lie back down then on the floor. So you have your cushions, whatever it is, and maybe a rolled up blanket underneath the hips, so that we're lifting the hips a little way up, a little bit higher up than the heart. Make sure you feel comfortable. Then remember, this is about releasing and relaxing in the pose. So we don't want to be super high. We don't want to feel the glutes having to work. You can always just walk the feet a little bit further away from you this time if you prefer, because we're fully supported on the mat. Arms are going to just rest by your side unless you feel you'd like to put a little bit of support underneath the arms. And then come back to the breathing. And you've got the option of having the eyes open or the eyes closed. Thinking about the breath. So maybe it's just about telling yourself inhale, exhale. Maybe you want to find that even count of inhale to four and exhale to four. come into breathing. Every time you find the mind wanders, you lose your focus, concentration on the mat. Come back to the breath. Maybe just thinking inhale, exhale. Maybe counting to four on the inhale, counting to four on the exhale. Just for a bit longer. And this is our last restorative pose before we come back to lying on the floor into Shavasana, into our full relaxation. Take three more big breaths here. And when you're ready, if you can, we're just going to lift the hips up slightly so we can slide whatever support we've got in underneath. Otherwise, just move out the way. Take a stretch here if that feels good, or maybe you'd like to just have another little hug of the knees. And then we want to finish in our final resting place on the mat for Shavasana, relaxation. So one pillow back in underneath the head, finding a support to come in under the knees. So remember, make this support under the knees as big as you want. And when you're ready, we're going to come to lie back down on the floor. So grab, if you, again, if you want to cover yourself up with a cushion, a blanket or anything like that, you can. So even though this has been a restorative class, the focus has been on releasing and relaxing, we're just going to take this final Shavasana now to just help absorb that release from the body. So as you pause here now and just come to your comfortable position lying on the mat, maybe with the hands now by your side, notice how the body feels. If maybe the body feels different to how it was when you started. We're going to let the breathing go, so we don't need to think about the breathing anymore. Trying to keep the mind fully switched off.
In a moment, we're going to slowly start to bring ourselves out from our shavasana, our relaxation. If you have time and you would like to spend longer on your mat, just resting on the floor, by all means do spend as long here as you would like to take. If you know you need to now slowly bring yourself out of this relaxation, this shavasana, and get on with your day, we're going to begin to move the fingers and move the toes. Slowly starting to move the hands and the feet. Maybe bringing some little circles through the wrists and the ankles. And when you're ready, start to move your arms back past your head, giving yourself a stretch from fingers to toes as we start to wake the body up just a little bit more. Maybe you'd like to stretch a little bit more through the right side of the body from right fingers to right toes. And then repeating that on the left side, so you stretch a little bit more through the left side of the body, through the from left fingers to left toes. And then in your own time, bring your knees up in towards your chest. Take a little rock here from side to side. And then when you're ready, bring yourself round onto your side. Slowly make your way up to a comfortable sitting position, wherever that might be. And we're going to then keep the eyes closed if we can, and inhale, reach the arms up. Bring your fingers and your palms together at the top, and then slowly bring your hands down through to your center, to your heart. Bowing your head to your fingers. So just acknowledge your effort, your time here on the mat to pause, relax, release body and the mind. And seal your practice in with namaste. So when you feel ready, just slowly make your way through the rest of this time of just sort of clearing your mat and your bolsters, your props, your cushions away. It might be a good idea to actually just go and have a small drink of water now, and to just flush away any of the tension, the stress that's been released in the body, and also just to help you revive and wake up a little before you start to move on with the day, the evening, whatever you have ahead. I hope you liked and enjoyed that. If you did, maybe leave a thumbs up, leave any comments or questions below. And if you'd like to join me again on the mat in future, hit the subscribe button so you know when to keep up or when all our latest videos come out. Okay, take care now. Bye.